Hello students, assalamu alaikum. Today we are going to do bank reconciliation statement. We did errors, mashallah. Now first we have to understand what is bank reconciliation statement, and for that very purpose where is bank reconciliation starts, we should discuss first. See, this was a cash book. Actually, we made this cash book when we were doing cash book on YouTube. I made this cash book for you. Now see, there are two balances at the end of cash book. There are two balances. One is 30,740 debit balance of cash. Okay. And one is 50,292. That is the balance, debit balance at bank. Acha. Whenever you are solving any question in CIE and they're talking about balance, please be careful. They don't talk about balance CD. They talk about balance BD, not CD. Be careful about that. Getting my point clear? They always talk about balance BD. Okay. Now, balance BD of cash, 30,740. You can check this balance is correct or not. How? Open the drawers with the cashier and count the cash. The cash should be 30,740. If it is in the drawers of the office, it means this amount is correct. What about this? 50,292. How do you know that this amount, which your cash book is showing as a debit balance, that you have now 50,292 in your bank account, this amount is correct? How would you know? Getting my point here? So what happens? The bank sends you a bank reconciliation statement. And that bank reconciliation statement actually provides you that whether this balance of your cash book is correct or not. 99.99% the cash book balance BD does not resemble with the balance of bank statement. Getting my point there? So what we do with bank reconciliation statement? Bank reconciliation statement is not part of accounting system. It is not made by the bank actually. It is made by the business, the trader, by the partnership business, by the manufacturer, by the business actually, not by the bank. Not part of accounting system. It is just, it has been conventionally added into accounting. Are you getting my point clear? It was conventionally added into accounting. Are you getting my point clear? Kisi ne banaya hoga, aaj rahi ho gaya. Getting my point clear? So, today we are going to learn how to make bank reconciliations. For us, when we have balance in our bank account, bank is an asset account for us. For bank, our account with the bank, for bank, our account is a liability account. Be careful about that. Okay. So suppose the bank statement is also saying that you have 50,292 in your bank account. So for us, 50,292 is an asset. For them, 50,292 is a liability. Getting my point? So we are showing balance BD on the debit side. They will show balance BD on the credit side because this is an asset account, and for them, our account is a liability account. Please be careful about that. Are you getting my point here? Okay. Now class, this is a question. We have to do this question. Now see class, this is Donnie's cash book, and we are he has made the cash. Now these are the bank columns of the cash book. Okay, cash column of the cash book are not required. These are only the bank columns. What we have debited into bank and what we have credited from the bank, it's given. Okay, and this is bank statement. Bank statement is always formed in the running balance format of ledger. Okay, running balance format. Now see, first and most important thing, our cash book shows the opening balance on 1st July is 7,250. Okay, and this is the same. Now see, this balance, opening balance. They both are same. Okay, so it means opening balance on 1st July 7,250 debit, and bank is showing credit balance 7,250. We have this asset account, they have a liability account, and it is balanced. Now see what they have debited, what we have debited into bank account, they have credited. What we have credited into bank, they have debited. Simple. Now see, 2,500. This 2,500 is debit. Yes, 2,500 is credit on 10th July. So, okay. Done. They are same. Just leave them. Okay. Now, what about this 1,300? 19. We have debited Parker's check into bank 1,300. Yes. Done. Okay. Yes, this 1,300 has been debited. So, it is done. Now, this 1,000, we have deposited into bank, but this 1,000 did not appear in the bank statement. Likewise, this 125 is credited by bank, but we don't know it. Okay. Now, 4,600, they have debited, and we have credited. Yes. Done. It is done. They are done. Okay. No need to discuss. 2,400. Robinson's check. We have issued to Robinson 2,400. Okay. And here is the check of Robinson. Done. No discussion. 1,100. A check of 1,100 we have issued to Kelly. No sign of it. Likewise, this 1,300, the Parker's check of 1,300 was dishonored. No sign of it. We don't know that. The check was dishonored by the bank. Okay. $100 they have charged from our bank account as bank charges. We don't know that. Okay. Now, according to the bank statement, your closing balance is 2,775. We don't know our closing balance is the requirement. Calculate the closing balance of 31st July 2020. Okay, so we are calculating here the closing balance. How to calculate? All the debit 7,250 plus 2,500 plus 1,300 plus 1,000 minus 4,600 minus 2,400 minus 1,100. Answer is balance CD is 3,950. See, this 3,950 shows that we have 3,950. If the CD is on that side, the BD on 1st August must be on this side. Hello. It shows that we have. Now, according to this cash book, we have $3,950 in our bank account. Bank says you have only $2,775 in your account. Okay. So, first we have calculated the closing balance. This is done. Now, prepare a revised or updated cash book. So, what we do, we will make a revised cash book in the T account form. date, description, debit, date, description. Done. Now this T account or cash book is ready. Okay. Now this T account is formed. This T account is a skeleton form. I have made it in standard form. Okay. Now see. This is called revised, updated cash book. Okay, now the date is July 31st. Okay. So every date of revised cash book would be July 31st. Balance. BD. According to revised cash book is 3,950. Now in revised cash book, we have to record only those items which are recorded by bank, but not recorded by the business. First is this 30 unit. That was, we don't know that. So what we have to do when bank has debited, we are going to credit it 1300 on July 31st. That is Parker. Okay. Oh my God, what's happening? This is Parker. Now, bank credited 125, we will debit. 125. 31st July. And name is debited. And again, bank had debited 100. We don't know it, so we'll credit 100. Reason, date same, 31st July, and bank charges. Done. Now, according to revised cash book, the total is debit 3950 plus 125, 4075. And if you deduct minus 1300 minus 100, the balance CD is 2675. Balance CD 2675. So the total here is 44,075. Done. On August 1st, balance BD at bank is now 2675. This is called revised and updated. Now, one more thing, very important. Suppose someone asks you, okay, what balance of cash at bank will be reported in the balance sheet of this business? The answer is balance brought down, reported in revised, updated cash book at the end is going to be reported in the balance sheet. This amount is going to be recorded in balance sheet. Are you getting my point, Clem? This amount. Okay. Now, what we have to do, we have to make bank reconciliation statement. Bank. Here we need our capital. Okay. Now, bank reconciliation statement we have to make. So, what we have to do? We have to insert a table. Okay. balance as per revised cash book. What is the balance as per revised cash book? We have $2,675. Now what we have to do? In bank reconciliation, we will record those items which are reported in cash book but not reported in the bank statement. This 1,000 and this 1,100. Debit, we deduct. Credit, we add. So this 31,000, we will deduct. Debit on the debit side. Less uncredited deposits. 1,000. What we are going to do, we are going to write it in credit. And what about this debit side? A check issued to KLA. We have issued a check to KLA, but KLA has not yet collected any money from our bank account. The check is still with him. So this is called outstanding check. So we use add outstanding check. And the amount is 1,100. So what would be the answer? Let's check. 2,675 minus 1,000 plus 1,100. 2,775. 2,775. Have you seen this amount somewhere? Yes. Here is the amount. So balance as per bank statement is your answer, actually, in this question. Suppose this comes in your exam. So you know this is the answer. 2,775. This is the answer. Yes. Balance as per bank statement. Done. This is how we make bank reconciliation statement. So what are the maximum requirement? Calculate the closing balance of cash book, revised and updated cash book, and bank reconciliation. This is, that's all. Getting my point clear? So this is all about bank reconciliation statement. Okay. So if you like the channel, please subscribe my channel. And if you want me to solve something special for you, just leave a comment, I'll solve it for you. Okay. Thank you. Take care. Allah Hafiz.